Lord Jesus. Lord Jesus. Lord Jesus.
Verse 14. Verse 14. Your soul. Verse 14. But you gotta say amen.
Amen.
For we know that the law is spiritual, but I am carnal, sold under sin.
Oh Lord.
For that which I do, I allow not.
That's the word.
For what I would do, that I do not. But what I hate,
Lord Jesus,
that do
oh,
I.
Master.
If then I do that which I would not, I consent unto the law that it is good. Verse 17. Now then, it is no more I that do it, but sin
all right now
that dwelleth
in me.
For I know that in me, that is in my flesh, dwelleth no good thing.
No good thing.
For to will is present with me, but how to perform that which is good, I am not.
How?
For the good that I would do, not, but the evil which I would not, that I do.
Lord Jesus.
Now if I do that I would not, it is no more I that do it, but sin that dwelleth in me.
All
I find in law that when I would do good, evil
Lord Jesus
is present with me.
All right now.
For I delight in the law of God after the inward man.
After the inward man.
But I see another law in my members warring against the law of my mind.
Yeah.
Bringing me into captivity to the law of sin which is in my members. Verse 24, which is the best verse I love. Oh wretched man that I am.
Uh-huh.
Who
all right.
shall deliver me from the body of this death?
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Thank God. Thank God. Thank
who
God.
Who shall deliver me from the body of this death? You may be seated in the presence of God.
Amen. Lord Jesus.
If I could place a title to this text, Brother Gardner, it would be Oh Wretched Man That I Am. Oh Wretched Man That I Am. We are saved by grace. We're saved by grace. The Lord has given us another opportunity to meet His glory.
All right now.
He has allowed us numerous opportunities.
Amen.
To meet His glory.
Lord Jesus.
Oftentimes, God doesn't give us not just one chance.
All right. All right.
God gives us two
all
chances.
Right. Amen.
Three chances.
Amen.
Four chances.
Yeah.
If you're like me, four times 40 chances.
All right, yeah.
And I thank God that He hasn't taken away my chances.
Amen.
Before I die.
All right. All right. All right.
This
praise His holy name.
Christian walk.
Christian
it's
walk.
Not an easy walk. I'm not for sure how many seasoned Christians we have in the building
Lord
this
Jesus.
Morning. But I want to share with everybody that as long as you're on this journey,
all right,
there are going to be some ups and some downs.
Yes, sir. Amen. Amen.
There are
Amen.
Going to be some smiles and some
Amen.
Frowns.
Amen.
There are going to be, Brother Gardner, there are going to be some good days.
That's all right, sir.
There are going to be some bad days.
Amen. Amen.
But as I've been walking this walk, Sister Mellors, I realize that as I look back on the scale,
all right,
I see that my good days.
All right. Hey, hey.
Yes, yes.
Hey.
Always.
Always.
our way.
Yeah.
My bad business.
Oh, that's good. That's good.
Many times my flesh tells me that I got more bad days than I got good days, but the Spirit of God tells me that if I'm still here,
God
will give me another opportunity
to
be near His cross.
Amen.
So I can just wake up another day. He has given me another opportunity to be at His cross. If I can just open my eyes another day, He has given me another opportunity to be near His cross.
Yes, sir.
But I wake up in the morning, Brother Gardner, finally opening my eyes and going down to my knees and thanking God for waking me up to see another day. But
that's
it seems
right.
Like as my day goes on, if I'm not prayed up, this old wretched flesh of mine wants to take over. This old flesh of mine wants to be in control. This old flesh of mine wants to drive my car and drive the steering wheel.
All right.
Every now and then I tend to look over to the flesh and think about some days when I had in my fleshly
all
days.
Right
and think about some old times that I had when
all
I was
right.
in my flesh. And
reality.
Truth be told, I had some good times back in the day. Y'all might be too holy right now to understand where I'm going right now, but back in my days, I did like what I used to do. Can I be real up in the day? Back in my day, I did have some exciting times and some joyful days, and I did have some fun days, and but I didn't realize after those days passed, that I woke up sick, and I woke up hurt, and I woke up in pain, and matter of fact, some days I didn't even go to sleep.
Glory to God. Come on, preach to us. Preach to us.
And I realized that I was walking dead.
All right. Walking dead.
That's why the old hymn, the old spiritual Negro hymn was that I was once blind. But now I can see. And I was once in the dark, but now I'm in the light. And the pastor told me when I first transformed my life over to God and surrendered, he said that I'm going to let you know that on this walk that it's not going to always be peaches and cream.
All right,
this Christian journey, don't think that you are exempt from being tempted. You are exempt from having trespasses. You are exempt from the enemy coming in. Tapping at your door. Don't think because you pray two or three times a day that the devil's not going to come knock on your door. You fast two or three times a week that the enemy not going to come knock on your door. You pay your tithes every month that the enemy's not going to come up and knock on your door. And I come to tell Corner Gate this morning that the devil may knock on my door.
Yes, sir.
But somewhere in the text it says, if God be for me, who could be against me? If this flesh gets weak, the spirit that dwells in me can overcome any type of knock. I don't know if you had a knock this morning, but just this morning I had a knock on my door, and the enemy told me that I ain't worthy to stand before God's people. And last night I had a knock on my door, and the enemy told me that I wasn't worthy to be doing the will and the work of the Lord. And just last week, the enemy knocked on my door and told me that I wasn't worthy to be a man of God. But if you know the scripture like I know, the Bible says that all things grow together for those who love the Lord and call according to His purpose. He never my flesh may be wrong. I know that the Spirit of God will take this role. And we see the book of Romans here. We see Paul, the Apostle Paul, was writing to the church of Rome. And he was telling the church of Rome that even though I've been in this ministry for the past 25 years, that every now and then I still struggle. Even though I've been in this ministry and wrote one third of the New Testament, every now and then I still struggle. He said, even though I've been in this ministry for the past 25 years, that enemy tends to knock on my door. But he says that even though the enemy tends to knock on my door, he says, I serve somebody.
nobody here this morning? Come on, Lord. Have never been through nothing. Nobody this morning has never been tempted. Have never been tried. Have never thought about your past. But in the Bible it says that we all have sinned and fall short of His glory. And every now and then I might sin, but God keeps giving me.
But God. God. Yeah.
He keeps me.
Yeah. 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 Thank you, Lord Jesus.
God.
Yeah.
He covers me.
Yeah. He does.
God.
It's all right.
He leads me.
Yeah, He does.
God. He controls me.
Yeah, yeah,
but I want to tell somebody on this morning, if you're not prayed up, then let no flesh will try to creep into your body and try to tell you that what you are doing for the Lord, that you're not worthy to do. And the little flesh will walk in the spirit and tell you that you're not able to be a conqueror. But somewhere in the text, it tells me that if I walk in the spirit, I would not fulfill the lust of the flesh. So I tell that devil, get away from me, Satan, because I'm more than a conqueror.
More.
Is telling the church that he struggles every now and then. And the thing that I love the most about Paul, Brother Gordon, he wasn't scared to confess
his faults. That's all right.
See, we think that we're in a leadership position and that we've been holding it down for the past 30, 45 years and that we can't share our faults with nobody. We can't confess what God saved us through. We can't tell nobody that we're struggling in this area. We can't tell nobody that we're struggling in this area because they'll look down on us. But I want to let you know the same folks that's looking down on you, when they look in that mirror, they looking down on themselves. That's why you got to confess your faults one to another, because when you don't overcome it, you got to express yourself and tell somebody that I believe in a God that can help me. And if you don't want to hear it, I know who I can confess to, because my God, He listens to me. My God, He talks to me. My God, He helps me when I'm down. He picks me up and He keeps me. Come on, in the blue.
Lord Jesus.
I don't do it.
Yeah. That's Lord. Master.
I want to do it.
I want to do it.
But I've been doing this here for the past 30-some years.
Lord Jesus.
I'm used to doing that.
Master.
Yeah. Because I'm comfortable in doing that.
Yeah.
Glory to God.
Yeah.
I've been doing this for the past 10, 12 years.
All right.
But for that 30-some years,
all right,
I was comfortable doing that. It's easy to me.
That's
I can do with my eyes closed.
All right.
But what I want to do, I don't do it. Lord, I'm struggling with some things in my life. But He says, oh, wretched man, who can deliver me? That's why you had a fellowship with your brother and sister day in and day out. Because if you be by yourself, that devil will pull you, will tug you, and will grab you. But if you got a brother, if you got a sister, or even a grandmama, that can help you. Oh, glory to God. That can help you.
It's all right.
Yeah. When you're down.
Yeah. Yes.
But he says, every time I try to do right,
every time,
evil is always present. Evil is always present.
Always.
You have to understand. He's not only talking about your neighbor.
No, sir. All right now.
He's not talking about somebody next to you. He's not talking about that man or that woman.
That's all right.
Or that husband or that wife.
All right there. Make it plain.
something and it ain't nowhere around. When you think about something, it ain't nowhere around. When y'all glory to God, y'all not feeling me. The evil present is not your neighbor. Sometimes the evil person can be deep down inside of you. That's why you gotta feel your cup up with the Spirit of God. And no, you ain't no I walk through the valley of the shadow of death. I shall fear no evil, cause God is with me. He's my rod, he's my staff. Oh, glory to God. The God be with you.
All right now.
He says,
God
be. He says, when I find in the Lord, that when I will do good, even his presence. He says, but I delight in the law of God
after the inward man.
That's why
delight.
I don't be quick to judge folk.
All right. Amen. Amen, Pastor. Amen.
Because the same law you trying to pull out there.
All right.
Yeah.
Hey.
You got that telephone pole.
Come on, help.
I might mess up. Every now and then, I might fall.
All right.
Every now and then, I might have some thoughts. Every now and then, I might smell something. Every now and then, I might drive this way. Every now and then, I might fall. But somewhere in the book of James, he says, count it all joy. Not if you fall, but when you fall. Like y'all ain't been through nothing. Like y'all ain't never, the devil ain't came and tapped on your door. You act like you ain't never came by your house. You act like you ain't never shattered your marriage. You act like you ain't never shattered your job. Y'all act like y'all ain't never had nothing done in your life. But I want to tell you, if you ain't never had nothing to shatter your house, just keep living. Because you are not exempt from being tempted. You are not exempt from being tried. You are not exempt. But the evil one, but if you keep moving, you ought to know that no matter how hard, I gotta keep standing. I gotta stand for the Lord. If you've been tried, somebody stand and give God glory.
Lord Jesus.
Tends to nag at me.
Yeah, nag.
That old man tends to nag at me.
Yeah,
nag. Matter of fact, that old tongue tends to nag at me.
Yeah.
He said something to me last week. I thank God that I'm saved.
All right.
Because I would have said something and it wouldn't have been scripture.
All right.
Oh, glory to God.
All right.
I'm still, he's still working on me. Hit me in my face, I might hit you back. Talk about me, I might talk back about you.
Right.
I'm not where I want to be, but I thank God that I'm better than where I used to be. I got some shortcomings, I got some downfalls, but God has kept me.
It's all right.
I might stumble. Now, I will stumble.
Yes.
I will fall.
Yes.
But just because I haven't overcome it quick as you have, don't look down your nose at me. Because the same way God's working on you, he's working on me too. Because what I, oh glory to God, what I overcome, you might still be struggling with it. I tend to have some good days and some bad days. Because I have no quicker than you.
Hey.
Matter of fact, I might not never overcome.
All right now. Right. Talk about it. Yes, sir.
I might not.
Yeah.
But do that make God not love me more than he loves you?
All right
now. Come on, Pastor.
Hey.
Come on,
Pastor. Hey. Hey. It's all right.
That's why I say a lot of us got skeletons in our clothes.
Yeah.
But a lot of us got some cemeteries in our closets. You got more bones than I got in your closet. Let me take your name on. Your closet is so big, full of skeletons, in the land. Oh, glory God, let me see.
Come on, help, Pastor.
Charge and you be charged now.
All right.
Yes.
All right.
Yes.
We all do some things.
It's all right.
That's not pleasing in the sight of the
Lord.
All
right.
We all think about some things.
Yes, sir.
That's not pleasing in the sight of the Lord.
Oh.
We all. Some of us even dress differently than how you dress.
That's all right.
But if you don't like what I got on, then you go buy me an outfit.
Amen. Lord Jesus.
Because no matter how I walk, how I talk, how I dress, up in my house, we will serve the Lord. And when we come to go together, we're going to give God glory and God praise. You can all last week, I've been through hell. I've been through some things last week. You might not know. I fell last week. You might not know. I was down last week. You might not know. But nothing can separate me from the love of God. I will glory God. No matter how hard I fall, I still love him. No matter how hard I fall, still love my God.
Come on.
Jesus.
You can't let no man,
Jesus.
No woman,
Jesus.
No husband, no wife,
nothing.
No drugs, no alcohol,
nothing.
Separate you from the love of God. That's why Sister Diddy says, trust in me with all the heart, lean not to your own understanding.
Got it.
But he also says, acknowledge me.
Come on here, Pastor.
Yes, sir.
See, Brother Brian, all covers everything.
Yes, sir. All covers everything. Amen.
I know some folks who are not preachers, but when they get drunk, they says, acknowledge me in all thy ways.
Yeah.
He said, when I get full, acknowledge me in all thy ways. You can't forget about the Lord, no matter what he takes you through. Tell me like you drunk, but steal. In
all
your ways.
All your ways. Covers everything.
Acknowledge me.
Yeah.
And I will direct your path.
Jesus.
Just because you fall down, get back up.
All
yes, sir.
Right.
Yeah. Yes,
Jesus,
sir. Don't
Jesus,
stay there.
Jesus.
But you understand, the higher that God elevates you. The harder the fall.
That's right.
Yeah.
The higher the level, the more the devils.
They after us.
Because Satan got kicked out of heaven, but he didn't leave by himself.
All right.
Amen.
The Bible says he took one third.
One third.
Of the angels.
One third.
With him.
One third.
That's why we get to sin. The devil loves cover. Sometimes when folks want you to do some things that you're not supposed to do, it's not them, but it's the evil man that's present by them. That's why you gotta be careful who you surround yourself with.
Yes, sir.
Because everybody that's with you is not for you.
It's all right.
Everybody that's praying is praying against you.
All right.
Some folks. P-R-E-Y.
Praying
against you.
Hey.
Because jealousy and deceit is always against your heart.
All right.
A smile on your face.
Oh man, that sword.
Stabbing you in your back.
Every time.
But I can't get mad at you because you know what?
Hey.
I allowed you to get close to me.
All right.
If I wouldn't allow the enemy in my presence, he wouldn't know what my next move is.
All right. Hey.
But everybody got And sometimes the adversary used folks, and they don't even know they're being used by the adversary.
That's right. That's right. God bless you, Pastor. God
so every time you, I want to do right.
Every time.
I do wrong.
Yeah. Yeah.
Every time I'm doing wrong,
yeah,
I want to do right.
Lord.
I'm warring
yeah
against myself.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's why they say I gotta clean up.
All right.
What a messed up.
All right.
I gotta start my life over again. But I thank God that mercy and grace follows me every day of my life. Because in the one night for the Lord. So I thank God, one day on the way to Calvary, he went by my little old spirit. He picked